So welcome dear students to computer studies chapter number 4 part 1. In this video you have to learn how to create list, that is ordered list and unordered list. And the next topic which is there in this chapter is how to create a table in HTML. In this part we will be learning about how to create the two types of list. We all are familiar with the words list. For example, a list of materials to be taken for the picnic, list of things to be carried for the exams, right? Now, sometimes it is necessary to prepare a list instead of typing the contents as a paragraph. Now, we all are familiar with Microsoft Word program. In Microsoft Word, we get a facility of preparing list. We get two options there. First option is ordered list, in which we can give 1, 2, 3, 4, that is numbering, or A, B, C, D. Different options we get. And another one is unordered list, that is bullets. So in Microsoft Word, we have got two things, bullets and numbering. Now, suppose if we want to do the same thing in Notepad, then we have seen that even if we type the word, suppose first item is chocolate, second item is ice cream, third item is pastry. If we want to prepare the list of these three items, then if in the Notepad we write it in separate, in different lines, but in browser it will be displayed continuous as a single line, right? So, how to prepare a list in HTML, that is web page, that is prepared using different tags. Here we get the facility of preparing both the kinds of list, that is ordered list, that is numbering, and unordered list, which is bullets. So, first we will learn unordered list. In unordered list, each list item starts with a symbol, that is like a bullet. To create an unordered list, we have to use UL tag, wherein each list item is displayed using a tag called li. We will practically do the thing, so we will be able to understand the concept clearly. So, first we will open the Notepad program. First thing is, we will save the file with the name unorderedlist.html inside our folder name 10 standard HTML files. First tag I am typing is HTML, head, title. In the title, we will give the title as learning unordered list. I made a spelling mistake, but let it be. Slash head, slash body, sorry, only body. Then, now we want to prepare an unordered list, so we have to use the tag UL. But before that, we will give in a heading that we are going to prepare a list of unordered things. So, I will give a heading using H1 tag, unordered list, H1 slash H1. Now, I will start with the tag UL. Now, which items I want to include in this list? Then, chocolates, pastry, and ice cream. So, I will type those things. Then, I will close UL tag by typing slash UL. Now, these all are list items, so I have to mention it to the browser that those are items, but list items. So, I will type the tag li, okay? Then I will copy and paste it before each items. Now, actually, I have to type slash li, but even if I don't type, it will work. It will not create any problem. So, straight away, I type slash body and slash html. Now I will save the changes in the file by pressing Ctrl S and open the file through browser. Now here we can see that the list is prepared and bullets are given to each list item, black color bullets. Now here we get an option to change these bullets to squares or to hollow circles. For that we have to use the attribute type. How to use? Let's see. We will go to the notepad program and change the type. So inside UL I have to type the attribute type is equal to into double quote square. Let's see the effect. Control S. Now here you can notice that from circle it has turned into square. Another value which type attribute has got is circle. If you type circle, then it will display hollow circle. So I hope besides unordered list and ordered list, in HTML you can prepare one more type of list, and that is list without bullets or without numbering. In case you do not want any bullets or any numbering, you may use description list using the tag pairs of DL and slash DL. In between DL and slash DL you have to use two tags. First one is DT tag, that is the term which you want to describe, that you have to type here, and DD means the definition of the term you can type after DD. Practically we will do it. So in the notepad I will type DL first, then I will type the term chocolate, then we will describe three types of chocolates. First I will type here chocolate. Then definition data, in that I am going according to the textbook. Here actually it should be a definition, but I am typing what is there in the textbook. That is the three type of chocolates are given here, that is dark, fruits and nuts. And milk. Now I am putting slash DL. Let's see the output. Control S. Documents. So here you can see the list which is prepared is without any sort of numbering or any bullets. Now we will do little bit what is given in the textbook. So what is given in the textbook is first thing that here we have used UL type is equal to circle. There are three different types, that is square, disk and circle. So here we have to copy paste these things, same thing, and in all the three list we have to use different types. Another thing, here we have given the heading H1 unordered list, that also we will change as it is given in the textbook. We will change it to an unordered list in various formats. Now, before copy pasting the same thing, here I will give a subheading as per the textbook, that an unordered list in unfilled circle bullets, that is written in the textbook. So I will copy this thing, and since it is subheading, so I choose H2, unordered list in unfilled circle. That is actually this circle attribute, circle value is only used to show the unfilled circle. Slash H2. Now we will see the output. Okay, we are going on the right path. Heading, subheading. Now we will copy paste the same thing twice. Okay, now in the first one we have used unfilled circle instead of the second one, sorry. We will make it circle. Your type is equal to, sorry, square. And this bullets, actually when we don't give any value, by default it shows that black color bullet, which is known as disk. So here if we write, if we type type is equal to disk, then also it's well and good, and if we don't type anything, then also it will be the same, results will be the same. So here you can see three types of this thing, list. Okay, now next thing which is given in the textbook is that the font color of the headings have been changed. So we will also change it. So what to do, we have to use the font tag, attribute color is equal to blue. Now I have to close the font tag by slash font. Don't forget to close any of the tag. So first headings color has changed. Now we will change the font color of the second heading. We will change it to red. We copy and paste it for the next two times. Done. Okay. Now what are we to do? Slash font. Okay, now let's see the output. Okay, so we are getting the output. Now last thing in this web page is that as we have described three types of chocolates, same way we have to describe another two terms also. So what we will do is we will copy this much thing dt and 3dd and paste it before slash dl once and twice. Now in the first one let it be chocolate, and second one we change it to ice cream, and two flavors of ice cream we give, vanilla and chocolate chips, or we keep it fruits and nuts, no problem, to save time. Okay, then here the third DT, that is term, is which is given in the textbook, is dry fruits, and the two type of dry fruits which are given here are almonds and cashew nuts. So in this 2DD we have to type those two names. We will remove the third DD. Okay, so the coding of this web page is over. You have to do it practically. Just let's check the output. Okay, it is giving the output. The next type of list is ordered list. An ordered list contains items along with numbers, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that way we can prepare a list with numbers, or with alphabets also, that is A, B, C, D, capital also and small also. And also we can prepare an ordered list in Roman letters, first, second, third, like this, like that way. Then OL tag is used to insert an ordered list. As the name suggests, OL means ordered list. In unordered list it was UL. Further, OL tag has got two attributes, start and type. We had seen the type attribute in unordered list, that is type is equal to square, circle or disk, right? While here we have got two attributes, start also. Suppose if you want to start the list from roll number 9301, then you will have to mention start is equal to 9301, like that way. And type, it has got five different values. They are, it could be 1, then it will be 1, 2, 3, 4. Capital A, then A, B, C, D in capital, then small a. Then Roman letters, first, second, third. That also in capital and small. So now we will do the practicals for ordered list. So this much coding I have already typed in the notepad. HTML head. In the title I have given ordered list slash title slash head body. Now I have given the main heading as an ordered list with different type and start values. Okay, that is the main heading. We will display it in red color font, and a sub heading is an unordered list. Here we add as plural an unordered list with default type and default start value. So first one we will keep it with default value, whatever it comes, that is 1 2 3 4 as type, and start also it will start from 1. Okay, so here I have typed the list of three things: chocolates, ice creams and dry fruits. Okay, this much is ready. So first we will save the file and see the output. We will save the file with the name orderedlist.html in the same folder. Now let's check the output. So here we can see red color, big font size, H1, an ordered list with different types and starts values. An ordered list with default type and default start. It is default 1, 2, 3. Now we will copy and paste these items in notepad, and then we will change the type values, that is A, B, C, D and first, second, third, and like that we will prepare the list. So first I copy this thing, and since the type has got 5 values, so I will paste it for 4 times. Okay, copy paste is over. Now I will change the heading. Instead of default type, I will make it type is equal to A, capital A. And default start. We are not changing the value. If we make it default start is equal to 3, then it will start from C instead of from A. Now I will copy paste this thing again and again. I will remove the previous thing which I had pasted, because here the heading is more proper and it will save our time. Okay, now I start changing the value. From capital A I made it small a. Second time I make it I, capital I, that is it will be first, second, third. And fifth time it will be small I. The earlier thing which I had pasted I deleted. I'll save and then check the output. Oh my god, there is no change in the output. Everywhere it's displaying 1, 2, 3, 4. Why? Because I have not yet added the attribute type in any of the OL. Just see. So one by one I will add. So here type is equal to capital A. I had just changed the heading, that is why it was not showing any effect. Type is equal to small a. Capital I and small I. Now let's check the output. So you can see the value has changed. A, then small a, first, second, third. In the last one, it has not changed. That means I have made some mistake somewhere. Okay, so I have type is equal to small I in slash OL instead of new OL. So I will cut from there and paste it here. My mouse is not working properly, and that is why it is displaying all these things. Okay, I will give a refresh. Now you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, capital ABCD, small ABCD, first, second, third in capital and small letters. So I hope this much is clear. Now we will make the use of start value. Start attribute. So I will copy and paste this thing, or I will prepare new. We will prepare a class list. So OL start is equal to 9301. Now I will type the names of the items of 9C class. First I will give a proper heading also here. Ordered list with default type. And start value as 9301. At present, I will type only three names to save the time. Aman, Bhavik, Chintan / OL. So let's check the output. So you can see here it is starting from 9301. So like this way we can change the starting sequence of any of the list using start attribute. Now one more thing I have to complete in the practicals regarding list is a mixture of both the types, that is ordered list and unordered list. That is known as nested list. Mixture of ordered list and unordered list is known as nested list. We will prepare it. So first I will copy and paste the heading here. What should be the heading? Nested list we can keep. Okay, so we keep that heading. Now I want to add two main list items in UL, that is bullets. The first list item should be chocolates. So I type li chocolates, and the sub list of chocolates should be dark chocolates and fruits and nuts. So that I want to display in ordered list 1 and 2. So I will start a new OL inside that UL after first li. Just observe. If you don't understand, watch this video or this part of the video twice. Now the two subtypes of chocolates are dark chocolates and fruit and nuts. So two li I prepare in that OL. Now I have to close this OL by typing / OL. But the main UL continues, so I'm not closing that UL here by typing / UL. I copy and pasted that chocolates wala thing. Now here I replace it by ice creams. Flavor we keep the same, no need of changing the flavor. Now I give / UL. So these both are sub items of the main UL. Now we check the output. So you can see the main list is unordered list with bullets, and the sub list is with numbers, that is ordered list 1, 2, like that way. So welcome back to Computer Studies Standard 10th, chapter number 3, Handling Images in HTML, part 1. So here we complete this video Now today whatever I have taught you, you need to revise it. Practicals you have to do. Okay, then only you will be able to remember the things. If you have liked the video, please give a like to the video. So we meet again in the next video. Thank you. Goodbye.